Good morning, and welcome to Our Lady of Grace. All of our hymns for this Mass can be found in the Brown Catholic Community Hymnal. We do have several announcements. Aquinas Academy will host an open house this afternoon from 1 till 3 for any families interested in visiting the school. This is for preschool up through grade 6, and there are brochures on the magazine rack with information about Aquinas Academy. Today we will be taking up a one-time special collection for disaster relief. This collection will go to Catholic Charities of the USA to help those who need immediate emergency aid from the past year's storms and natural disasters, which left many without food, water, shelter, and medical care in the South and the Midwest regions of the country, and we thank you for your generosity. All liturgical ministers, EM servers, and lectors who do not have email may pick up a copy of the new schedule on the magazine rack after Mass. Please be sure to take a bulletin home for details and other announcements. You may also visit our website and read the bulletin online. We ask that you please silence or turn off all cell phones and pagers in preparation for Mass. Please join in singing our opening hymn number 375, The Summons. We will sing verses 1, 2, and 3. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, each of us has responded to the summon of God to gather into this church to give honor, praise, and worship to our Heavenly Father. Let us do so with a humble and contrite spirit as we acknowledge our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. But do you gird your loins? Stand up and tell them all that I command you. Be not crushed on their account, as though I would leave you crushed before them. For it is I this day who have made you a fortified city, a pillar of iron, a wall of brass, against the whole land, against Judah's kings and princes, against its priests and people. They will fight against you, but not prevail over you, for I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation. I will sing of your salvation. In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear to me and save me. I will sing of your salvation. Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. Oh my God, rescue me from the hand of the my trust, O God, from my youth. On you I depend from birth. From my mother's womb you are my strength. I will sing of your salvation. My mouth shall declare your justice. Day by day your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth, and till the present I proclaim your wondrous deeds. I will sing of your salvation.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. If there are prophecies, they will be brought to nothing. If tongues, they will cease. If knowledge, it will be brought to nothing. For we know partially, and we prophesy partially. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk as a child, think as a child, reason as a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. At present, we see indistinctly, as in a mirror, but then face to face. At present, I know partially. Then I shall know fully, as I am fully known. So faith, hope, love remain, these three. But the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus began speaking in the synagogue, saying, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke highly of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They also asked, "Isn't this the son of Joseph?" He said to them, "Surely you will quote me this proverb, 'Physician, cure yourself,' and say, 'Do here in your native place the things that we heard were done in Capernaum.'" And he said, "Amen, I say to you, no prophet is accepted in his own native place. Indeed, I tell you, there were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the sky was closed for 3.5 years and a severe famine spread over the entire land. It was to none of these that Elijah was sent, but only to a widow in Zarephath in the land of Sidon. Again, there were many lepers in Israel during the time of Elisha the prophet, yet not one of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian." When the people in the synagogue heard this, they were all filled with fury. They rose up, drove him out of the town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town had been built, to hurl him down headlong. But Jesus passed through the midst of them and went away. The Gospel of the Lord. Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning, everyone. Certainly like to begin my homily by acknowledging that each year, at the end of January into the first week of February, the Church in the United States celebrates Catholic Schools Week. And as such, we acknowledge the students, the families, the faculty, all those who make up our local Catholic schools, whether it be Aquinas Academy, Greensburg Central Catholic High School, Middle and High School, or Clillian Heights School for Exceptional Children. Those who work and to make those places such vibrant communities of learning, as well as filling them with faithful service and handing on our Catholic tradition and faith, we commend them for their efforts and celebrate your success and pray for your future endeavors. Today, as we hear God's word, there is a common theme that truly is very evident, most clearly, in that second reading from Paul, his first letter to the Corinthians in that 13th chapter, in which we are so familiar because we hear it frequently in celebrations of marriage. For Paul writes so eloquent and beautifully about the nature of true Christian love. He speaks so eloquently of it. In our world, we often equate love with softness, with gentleness. It is for many times we think those who fall in love are weak or vulnerable. Certainly is one aspect and facet of love. But yet for those who are Christian, those who follow the way of Jesus, we realize it takes a strong person, a committed person, to truly embrace authentic love, love that endures. That reading from the prophet Jeremiah reflects the very nature of love, where we hear the prophet reveal that even in your mother's womb, God knows you. Such a beautiful, powerful statement of faith that we take to heart and reflect upon in our Mass today. We look at our lives amazingly as they are, to know that somehow we have been called and been known by God our Creator even before we entered into this world in our mother's womb. Such a proclamation of faith is why we as a people of God, a people of faith, proclaim the sanctity and dignity of all human life, because it has its origin in God our Creator. As we hear in today's gospel, that Jesus in his own native place proclaims in the synagogue that the word of Scripture is fulfilled in their hearing. When he proclaims such beautiful words, they all speak well of him. But he goes on to speak some challenging words in that synagogue, words that did not fall on good ears. And they became angry and indignant. As a matter of fact, we hear that they drive him out of the synagogue, out of the town, to the brow of the hill, intending to hurl him over the cliff. But we hear Jesus walks through them, right through their midst. When you reveal and interpret that passage, interpreting, understanding that Jesus is love, that when love comes and with a soft and a very wonderful message, when we encounter people that we fall in love with and we naturally have an affinity for, we speak well of them. But it is when love is challenged, when it meets resistance or in difficult, that is when we need to truly turn to our faith, turn to the grace of God, to fill our hearts with mercy and recommitment. Each one of us in this church, as we celebrate our faith today, has a heart, the capacity of love. And for many, thankfully and joyfully, that heart is full of good and warm love. Like the beginning of that gospel, the gracious part of love. But others perhaps are tasting the bitterness of love, painful loss, troubles and traumatic moments in relationships. Perhaps we too call upon God to deepen our faithfulness and understanding of why these things are happening to us. We ask the divine Heavenly Father to touch our hearts, to renew the spark of love and faithful commitment. We offer our prayers for those who are hurt, bruised, and broken in their relationships of love. We bring them to the altar of God. And finally, as we come into this church today, I call your attention to the bulletin that you will receive when you leave church. I ask you to take that bulletin, and inside of that bulletin, I have written a letter. A letter that I wrote last week in the midst of a snowstorm. It gave me the opportunity to write some words that I've been meaning to share with you, our parish family. And instead of just reading them at your leisure when you go home, I want to take time now, concluding this homily, to voice them, because I want you to hear them with my voice as your pastor, with the tone and inflection that interprets the true nature that they were written with. For some time now, I have felt the need to share with our parish community my gratitude for the many ways you have embraced and supported me as your pastor, and for having responded so positively to the pastoral initiatives of evangelization, faith formation, and stewardship that I have presented to our parish since my arrival in June of 2013. More specifically, Christ life, growing in grace, renewing our model for faith formation of our children, the sanctuary renovation project, the increased offertory appeal. The success of each of these initiatives in its own way reflects the vitality and commitment of our parish community to our shared mission of faithful discipleship to Jesus Christ and His church. Our parish's first round of Christ Life last year served to ignite the spiritual life of over 200 members of our parish, while currently the second round is reaching out to an additional 50 parishioners. 60 adult parishioners are currently deepening their life of prayer by participating in Oremus. Oremus is our first of many to come, growing in grace opportunities for our adults. With Jesus to the cross will be our second, and it will begin in a few short days on February 8th, Monday before Ash Wednesday. Perhaps you have seen the flyer in the entrance of the church or the poster marking and advertising it. It will be held Monday evenings beginning February 8th for 7 consecutive Mondays. In addition to these adult faith formation opportunities, 120 parish children in preschool through grade 5 regularly participate in our renewed model of faith formation that blends Sunday morning catechesis twice a month with Sunday evening family sessions known as Ignite, periodically held throughout the year. I am pleased to announce to you that plans for our sanctuary renovation project are close to completion. And once they have been finalized and approved by Bishop Malesic, they will be posted in our gathering area for all parishioners and guests to see. The final cost of the renovation is yet to be determined because it will be based on the final plan. However, I am confident that our parish will have the necessary funds to complete it because of your generous support of last year's Diocesan Lenten Appeal and additional gifts that have been made toward the project. My hope is that the sanctuary renovation work will begin immediately after Easter. Last but certainly not least, your response to our increased offertory appeal has been overwhelmingly positive. Some 460 families have made a commitment to increase their weekly offering. Our parish offertories increased more than $3,000 a week. This increase to our regular offertory will enable our parish to continue to grow our parish ministry, outreach, and service in the areas of faith formation, evangelization of adults and families, and to meet the expected related expenses for the upkeep and maintenance of our facilities. As you can see, our parish family has many reasons to thank God for truly blessing us with success in these pastoral initiatives and to be hopeful as we look toward the future. Let us continue to prayerfully support one another in our mission to serve the Lord with gladness, bringing His everlasting love and mercy to others. Thank you for listening to those words attentively. They come from the depths of my heart because they are written with love, not a soft and mushy love, but a love that is committed to this parish. And as I look out, I see faces of members and families whom I know understand that love demands sacrifice, it demands commitment, it demands a strong heart committed to our faith in Jesus Christ. Lent is fast approaching. Lent is God's call to each faithful person to renew the strength of their heart in love. Please consider coming on Monday nights to learn more about our faith in Scripture, journey with Jesus to the cross. Or consider volunteering at our parish fish fries on Friday. Many members devote a lot of time and effort in the kitchen and serving meals and bussing tables. A particular need is for some strong men and perhaps young men to help clean in the kitchen at the end of the night all of the pots and pans and utensils that are used throughout the day. you find it in your heart, what a better way to give witness to your commitment to our parish, commitment to your younger children, that this church is important, that religion is important, that faith in God is important, by giving of your time and volunteering at the fish fries. And finally, each Lent there is a diocesan Lenten appeal in which you always hear the pastor or someone preach about giving more. You will not hear that this year. A coach knows when to back off the players and the team. All right? So I just trust in your goodness that you'll respond this year. Enough said. Let us love each other from the depths of our heart, for that love has its origin in God and our faith in Jesus Christ. May that Spirit of the Lord truly be renewed in our hearts, our minds, and souls this day, and as we look forward to celebrating Lent together. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With loving trust in the Lord our God, we humbly present before him our petitions.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the leaders of our church, that they may guide us in walking in the way of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For world leaders, that they may work tirelessly for peace, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who are suffering in mind and in body, that our Lord lovingly touch their hearts with the spirit of healing, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our friends and neighbors, that we may live in a loving and peaceful way with them, marked by a spirit of humility, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who put themselves in harm's way to defend, protect, and rescue those in need, may they know that we keep them in our hearts and prayers for a safe return home. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our dearly departed, including Polly A. Mahoney, may they rest in peace with all the angels and saints in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we believe the tremendous love that you have for us, and we know that you are present with us in our journey of life. We ask that you hear our prayers and answer them according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
As we present our gifts, please join in singing hymn number 354, May Love Be Ours, Lord, number 354.
May love be ours, Lord. May love be ours.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. O come. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. Amen.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I am strength for all the despairing, healing for the ones who dwell in shame. All the blind will see, the lame will all run free, and all will know my name. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I am the word that leads all to freedom. I am the peace the world cannot give. I will call your name, embracing all your pain. Stand up now and walk and live. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home, and of you and you are mine.
Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 375, The Summons, verses 4 and 5.